Hey everyone, this is my GVXS 306 back, and I just got this a few days ago and ordered it on Amazon and took a ride with it, and I am going to return this. I think it is great quality but has some major design flaws that I'm going to walk you through real quick. Let's start in the front with the first design flaw. That is this little strap here, which is pretty annoying. It's supposed to go around the center, the steering column, but you know, who really wants to fumble this through all this mess here every time they mount or unmount the back? You cannot take this off. It's sewn into the fabric. I mean, you can cut this off permanently, but then you have no buckle or anything to secure this. This side will face the ground and this will dangle down, which not only looks bad, but you can also like get stuck somewhere. Anyway, and the next more annoying design flaw is this part here, because it has this little notch, and as you can see here, it covers part of my screen. No matter how I put it in center, on the side, on the left side, it will always cover my screen. And for reference, that is a Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus. You could say like, hey, but dude, you can slide this down, but the issue here is that it's really difficult, you know, you're grabbing in here, so this flap here sits over the other flap, so it has a little Velcro. You would slide your phone in, and then getting it over the other side here is a little bit annoying, especially if you have like a charging cable attached to it. So you can do it, no question about it, but dare you, if you open this once, your phone will not only slide down towards the notch, but beyond somewhere here where I thought, okay, the phone has no business being here. They just made it so you can loop your cable around, although I would have more appreciated if the USB port would be somewhere down here, so the cable would go through the main compartment and not through all this stuff here, leaving this space for the phone to move towards the front of the flap, which also makes flipping over the flap a real pain. So that whole design is really flawed. So, but what about the iPad holder that they give you? Okay, let me attach the iPad holder. So I put on the iPad cover, which again, it clipped in here in the front, and this works much better with my phone. However, that also has this annoying notch that shouldn't be there. If you have like a bigger screen, the notch will also cover parts of your screen. The major flaw, however, in this design is that to open the whole thing, that you can only do with these zippers to get into the main compartment, you have to take off this Velcro strap. And they decided to not only put a Velcro strap there instead of like a clip buckle, so that would make things easier. No, they had to put in a Velcro strap and they had to attach the strap to the main body. And that, I would say, is the major flaw of this design if you're planning to use that iPad cover, because you always have to fumble around with this Velcro to get into the main compartment. They easily could have done something where they attach the pad to the front flap, the main flap, so that the pad opens with the main flap, but they decided to not do that, which was pure stupidity in my opinion. Really bad design. I was so annoyed by that. Anyway, the next thing that is really, well, disappointing rather than annoying, is the rain cover. So not the cover itself, I haven't tried it out. This is like a high quality bag. So I have a lot of camera bags and they usually have a weather cover, a rain cover integrated somewhere in the bottom or so. So you can open some compartment with a Velcro or a zipper and pull out the rain cover. And I thought they might do something like that, but no, they just gave you a pouch. And they just threw it in here. Fancied it up a little bit with a carabiner loop, but that doesn't do anything because I usually don't pour this out somewhere. So you just have like this thing eating up space in here if you decide to ride with it. So next thing also, this is just, it's not detachable. So it's just some annoying stuff flapping around in the main compartment. And speaking also of the main compartment, let me do a comparison to this $170 bag to my $80 Nelson bag. The whole compartment is just like one bulky space. And they even give you like some, I don't know, flaps, like some net with the rubber, so you can put like sunglasses in there and some nice pen holders or key holders or something, and it's easy to fill. $170 and they don't give you anything, no pen holder, no key holder, no whatsoever, except for this stupid thing. Sorry, I'm getting a little bit ranting here about this bag, but it's beyond me why they wouldn't put anything in here, like a net. You can put like some SD cards in there or something, nothing. Let's not dwell on the main compartment. Let's go to the side pocket. The material is super stiff. I mean, you could say that's good quality, but let's take an everyday item. That's not, I mean, keys, earplugs, something will fit in there, no question about it. But let's just take this slim sunglass case and slide it in my $80 Nelson bag, which I'm not trying to promote here, trying to get rid of it, but it fits, no problem. Let's try this here. And this is how far this will go, or that it's tiny. You cannot fit anything sizable in there. Earplugs maybe a slim wallet or something, but nothing else would fit in there. They could have easily solved that if that material would have been a little bit softer, a little bit wider, expandable or something, or the opening would have been wider, further down here, further up here, but they didn't. They decided to make this like a really tiny, tight little case. So this paired with no flaps, no nets, no nothing here, really leaves me struggling with this case being a good partner and putting like different items like sunglasses and my fast track transponder and all that stuff in here. It's just like not really good compartmentalized, and on the other hand also not good for huge bulky items because it's just so uneven in its wideness. So yeah, enough for the rant. I'm not meaning to diss that bag in general. Maybe it works for you, but I think you should know about all the design flaws that there are. And I think there are many, so I will return this bag and never look back. All right, thanks so much and good luck and safe riding out there.